What's up, YouTube? Again, the camera was taken from me. This is what we're going through right now. When it comes to taking care of your family or these people that you love and you want to see them happy, things like that. What I'm realizing that I can't take on these other people's goals because I took on the sadness that came with them. They stopped pushing their potential, which made them sad, which I took on, which I let fuel me. I let sadness be my fuel, not even my own fuel. Use somebody else's fuel. So I siphoned someone else's sadness, used that as fuel, as my creative energy to somehow achieve their goals, to somehow make them happy. So I tried to use their sadness to make them happy, which is impossible. It only makes them more sad. That's what I realized. That even if you do get to the point where, say, somebody has guilted you into achieving their goals, and then you do achieve them, you get to that point of exhaustion by doing it because your heart's really not in it. It's more so their heart. You know, you're not really, you're giving a piece of you up. You're investing you up for their passions. They're passing it on to you. Once you get to that pinnacle and you get to that goal that they have for themselves, then they resent you even more. Because now you are a physical representation of what they could be. So, honestly, that was one of the biggest things I had to let go in my life, holding on to other people's goals. So, anyway, I say anyway because anything can go anyway, I'm anywhere, we anybody. And like my sister, we were arguing the other day, not really arguing because I won't let the energies enter me. I mean, I let them come into me so I know what people are feeling, and then I turn it into whatever I want to turn it into. But what I realized, you know, with her, you know, one time when she was saying that nobody cares, and it's the truth that nobody cares. It's the body. I'm talking to just bodies. The bodies don't care. So it's the truth. It's just soaking in, and you're seeping in slowly, to slowly get it in. You know, you're slowly being this representation. So right now I'm at this point now where I'm done talking. I talk to you more than I talk in general on a day as far as the net. I talk to y'all more than my own family at this point because I'm not trying to be family anymore. I'm done trying. I'm done trying to be family, trying to save people. Trying is dying. That's what I'm realizing. There's no point. So I might as well detach. I might as well detach so that they can see it because I got to give them space. And they can see me from space and understand, you know, what everything represents, what everything represents. So it's, again, you know, it's just a rebirth. You know, again, I was born, basically a stillborn, basically into a corpse, going through a process of remembrance, really. Being born dead means you are at a void state. You're pretty much... You're void of emotion, pretty much, void of love and all that. That's what happens. You know, you don't expect a union that is absent of love to produce a body that is of love. So two people collide and there's no love in their union. It's like expecting Enron to be loving, expecting any merger to have a loving outcome. It's not a loving thing if it's a business outcome. So someone like myself coming into this body that was created out of a business deal, it allowed me to see life as a business deal. So to see the exchanges of life, to not be detached from it. So it allowed me to really see what everything for what it was. So that was my stillbirth, being stillborn. And it's just about the rebirth now. Just rebirthing, gonna just give it space, and I'm done talking. I'm really done talking. That's the end of it. And I got some other videos for y'all that are coming, and I'm going back to Cali on Christmas Day because it's just no point. It's just consumerism. Christmas has become consumerism. It's not what it was. You know, it's not what it is. Christ being the anointed one. It's just we're so not ourselves.